So one of the challenges for modern day medical education is that students are dispersed geographically across a very wide area. The other thing is that during the clinical years, the learning opportunities for basic science are very variable. So we decided to come up with the idea of actually creating a set of online modules called the Scientific Streams that would address that variability and that would allow students to learn at their own pace and in a self-directed way.
Within medicine, there's a number of skills students have to learn, from patient care all the way through to the physiology and genetics that underlie those conditions. So we need students to be able to apply all the way from the basic sciences through to the clinic. And we teach with that philosophy from foundational principles all the way through to the clinic.
The students do the scientific streams in years 3, 4, and 5 of the medical degree. Years 3, 4, and 5 align to the clinical rotations years, and that's when they go out into the hospitals, into the community, and actually practice the art of medicine. So there are 10 scientific streams. A student will be presented with a range of information and symptoms that a patient has, and we get students to read information and then to answer questions based on information that they've read. We might get them to think about investigations that should be done and what kind of investigations might be the most appropriate at that stage.
Even though I learn off a lecture, I feel I learn more off a scientific stream, doing it myself, researching it myself, and just typing out all of these notes with no time limit.
So what we try and do is actually make the modules engaging. So for example, we've got a module in the trauma and critical care scientific stream. We've got an audio snippet of an ambulance driver actually talking about a real scenario that happened.
I've got his vitals for you. His airway is patent, SATs are 96, BP95 systolic, and GCS is 14. At the moment, he looks like he's got his head, possible chest and abdo injuries, and a compound fracture of his left femur. We are on our way and we'll see in about 10 minutes.
So we try and give students a kind of authentic sense of what it really means to have a problem in an emergency department or a trauma setting. One of the things that's very important for us is to look at the student feedback. Because after students complete a module, they're required to provide us with feedback, and we use the feedback to constantly monitor and update the streams and to review them.
I like that we can go at our own pace. I think that's very helpful, and the fact that we can see other people's responses, we can see our own responses, view feedback, and it's very nice just to see where you've gone with it. As the future goes on, we're going to be more and more involved online. And just given how diverse and spread apart we are, I think it's very important for us to become comfortable around learning online and not being face-to-face all the time.